So Rob Ditto. You have to think about what am I getting out of reward? If I had to work hard to get in, what am I getting? If you're Marth and you're not spacing tippers at high percents, at low percent, all you're doing is getting a little bit percent versus somebody else who's getting significant reward. So we'll talk more about that afterwards. Right now, this one, this matchup is actually hilarious because it's entire, like, both of them are going to do the same thing. Who punishes Nair better on landing? Who utilizes gyro better? But the big key factor in who wins this matchup is two things. One, winning at ledge. B, who gets better grabs? Because if they don't, all the boxing in the world doesn't matter because they both understand how to get around these traps. They're not going to get caught by them in center stage. Never mind. They are going to get caught by them in center stage because Wadi's going to jump into the loving embrace of Apit Man's up smash.
Yeah, I think you said it really well, Ajax. The name of the story in this matchup is he who commits the Nair gets punished easily. He who wins the ledge wins first. And honestly, just look at the way the Ape Man plays. It's kind of good to see these two players come out and do the Rob Ditto. But also, whoever wins the Ditto isn't necessarily indicative of who's the better Rob main. It's players are just better at the Ditto than others.
See, so there are some characters in this game, particularly Rob, that can be played in like four different play styles. We say it every single time they show up because they're here every week. You can't look at Apit Man and also tell somebody how to beat Wadi. Now, Wadi is getting caught consistently on landing, so you're going to say Wadi, just keep swinging at Wadi while he's trying to touch the ground, but he's going to change it up eventually. But there's nothing that these two that they do similar enough to each other. You have to look at their habits differently. Oh. Great job going off stage and covering him after he went too low with that gyro. If he air dodged, he died anyway, so Apit Man kind of cornered on himself there.
Yeah, ultimately, I look at Dittos as whose play style is the one that counters one another, because it's like you said, Ajax, Apit Man plays a very different Rob than Wadi does. Wadi's Rob could be more suited to playing some of the more top players versus Apit Man could be overall suited to, you know, play most of the online players. And this isn't necessarily true, but this is an example of whose play style is the one that gets the big W at the end of the day. And judging by the looks of it, man, Apit Man is definitely one of those aggressive Robs that he's not afraid to go in and get those combos versus Wadi, who's a little bit more reserved and a beat and punish style. As you can kind of see, Apit Man is aggressive at this point.
Yeah, the best way I can... great reverse edge guard. If you commit too hard, that back air is still good off stage. The best way I can describe these two, Apit Man... Actually, Wadi is more of like a bait and punish, whereas Apit Man is swing first, ask questions later. Because he's going to take a look at how you respond to the actual swings and pressure he's putting on. Wadi likes when people behave erratically. That's why you see him get so many shadow balls off of down throws, because it's easier for him. A playstyle like Apit Man at the start is going to be annoying to deal with. As the set progresses, Apit Man needs to consistently mix himself up. Good job calling out that jump to the ledge. Mm-hmm. That's game one to Apit Man.
Yeah, and it's like you said, I think Wadi's ability to understand opponent's habits and the bait and punish ultimately comes down to his playstyle working really well with a character like Mewtwo, right? One of the things we've talked about so many times, even in Leon versus Johnny, is the ability to call out your opponent's landing and the bait and punish. You can just go for an empty hop and then punish your opponent's common reaction, which is usually directional air dodge, which has a lot of end lag, and you can just punish that with Shadow Ball. And with Mewtwo, you get so much benefits with Shadow Ball, especially if it's charged.
Facts. Also, something outside of the match here too, a big key factor when you're playing a matchup like this where it's not only a Ditto, which, you know, can be kind of stressful because you're in your head, all people who play Dittos do this. You start thinking, I wouldn't do this, so therefore they're probably not going to do this. And that's a bad way to look at it. You got to look at that matchup the same way you will look at every other matchup, which is a good thing that we're seeing out of these two. It doesn't seem like they're going to like behave that way. Two, I swear, I want people to be more like Wadi. Everybody should start handling matchups the way that Wadi does, because this dude will win or lose and have fun. He said it recently, and I love the way he explained it. If you're not having fun with what you are doing, why are you doing it in the first place? These pro players have good confidence because they, well, some of them enjoy what they're doing, but you know, if you have the positive mindset that you are going to win, and if you don't win, either learn something later or just have a blast with it, because it is what it is. So I would like to see people play a lot more or have Wadi's mindset more when they approach these things. Because matchups like this suck, but you got to learn them.
Honestly, you have a really good point. That's what I tell people. If you're going to do something, have fun with it. You know, don't, it's not a job. It's a video game at the end of the day. And if you're treating it like a chore, then you're not having fun. Effectively, essentially, you're the one losing. And I think Wada has good takeaways from that.
Yeah, so actually, I want to respond to something. So, Sammy, I'm glad you said that. So, I actually have a winning record against Sonics. And a big reason why I like to approach things is when I stare at a Sonic and I get a lead, if they're going to play campy, I'm going to giggle. I'm going to stay off to the back. And if they happen to get a lead on me, it is what it is. Like, look, a win condition is a win condition. Yeah, it sucks that you have to chase somebody down. Yeah, it's annoying. But sometimes it's either stage or you got caught a bunch on openings and you just play the clock with them. Make them confused. Behave in a way that they're not expecting and then just laugh about it. Because at the end of the day, a matchup is a matchup and somebody's going to play to win no matter what. That's a win condition.
Yeah. Honestly, you summarized it better. Well, I couldn't have said it any better than myself. Yeah, of course, but Wadi is going to be going to the Mewtwo. We talked about how good this character is for Wadi, and it goes really well with this playstyle. But Ape Man is a whole different beast, man. He's been the king of consistency here at MSM Online, always getting that top 8. Very rare that we don't see him in that special placing. We'll see how he can do it against Wadi now, because he gets that grab and he reads that landing almost with the confusion there, but that laser is able to stop him in his trank. And what a setup from Ape Man. He sets up the gyro there, so that if Wadi went for a get up, that back air was going to confirm. If he jumps, the back air will hit. It's a do or die situation.
Yeah, and if he gets caught being a little bit too erratic, you just get bounced right into Ape Man too. And this matchup is actually, I think, a pride for Wadi right now too, because Wadi had showed that he's only a few points behind Jake, like 10 points behind Jake on the current rankings. That's not the way you're going to get back to him, though. He's currently sitting in Grands, and you're teleporting right underneath a good call-out down there, but that Shadow Ball is going to do it.
Oh, what a great rollback there. Able to punish Ape Man for the neutral air. Like I said, one of the things we saw in the Ditto is he who punishes neutral air is the one who's able to effectively win. Wadi, same case and scenario here. He knows how the character works. He's been the character for years, so he knows what Ape Man is looking for when it comes to the neutral and in the air game too as well. That's one thing that he can definitely punish with Mewtwo as well. He can punish Rob for trying to go for those high recoveries, because that forward air, that up air, it ain't no joke.
I actually giggled because when somebody said petition to nerf Mewtwo's hitbox, he got hit on the reverse side by Gyro. I was like, yeah, you're right. So I really like the way that Wadi's approaching things. I think that the Mewtwo's working. Oh, that was great.
What did I tell you? That tail was no joke.
And what's one of the things that people do the most there, right? You get hit by side B. Oh, good job air dodging far enough in. He realized positioning was out of hand. But what are the things people do? They try to swing and they try to jump away. So that time, Wadi calls it out. This has been a very good switch for Wadi so far. And this is why I was saying Ape Man has to be able to keep that whole swing first, ask questions later approach going well throughout the set. Because otherwise, Wadi's behavior is going to adjust around it.
Oh, that was close too. And look at the way that Wadi had responded, just knowing that Ape Man might have gone for some kind of option, like a panic directional air dodge. And he could have called that out with Disable, but unfortunately, Ape Man had Wadi stuck on the platform here. Ape Man up at 98%. Wadi definitely poised to take this game, but we'll see if Ape Man has anything to do about it, because we know how he can turn things around with just a quick Rob combo. He's definitely really good at the corner carry to the Robo Arms.
Ape Man's gonna die or score off there. Oh, he tried. He tried right there. He got caught by the gyro. So Nair is gonna force. I like the fact that Wadi didn't try to approach. Oh, yeah, there it is. What did I say? What did I say?
I told you guys. That short hop fair, that tail is no joke.
So if you pay attention to the way that Wadi was behaving at the end of that stock, you saw that he was going for grabs. He was trying to get him in a spot where he'd be afraid to get off the ground. But he started grabbing him a bunch. He caught him with the side Bs, tried to get him with the Shadow Ball, and he started throwing him a bunch like that forward throw. What does that do? That conditions somebody to jump, especially at high percents. Wadi knew it. Wadi knew that the trade would be fine if he traded with his fair, and he took him out. Now, here's the funny thing. I actually don't think Wadi's going to play Mewtwo the entire set. I actually think that if it goes to game 4, Wadi switches back, probably because of counterpick.
Yeah. And for good reason.
My reason? I think it's purely based off of what they leave open. Where did we start? What was
I was going to say for good reason, but I guess...
Oh, I thought you said what was the reason.
No, you're good.
Yeah, so like I would like to see him stay the Mewtwo, but I think that if, like, say Wadi goes up 2-1 here, and then Ape Man runs it back on game 4, we probably see the switch. But it all depends.
I think I see chat talk about buffing Mewtwo. Honestly, Mewtwo is a buff away from just being the most broken character in the game. Well, not the most broken. Just being like arguably a top tier character. Some characters are just one buff away from being top tier. And it's crazy.
There are quite a few. Also, I just realized that I said that incorrectly before. I was saying nerf the hurt box on the tail, not nerf the actual tail's like hitbox. No, God no. I just realized I confused chat. My bad. But here, let's see. I'm somewhat surprised it seems like we're running it back. But no. It looks like we're gonna switch stages. I didn't really like Town City there for Ape and Man. That center platform is actually extremely good for Mewtwo. It's like a really good getaway from gyro setup. So where did he go? FD? Oh, he ran back to Town City.
Yeah, Town City, okay. I was gonna say interesting choice. Nonetheless, here Ape Man starts off with a full committal of the Nair here, seeing that Wadi is in the corner, might as well take advantage of it and make sure you pressure him as much as possible. You know, Ape Man's not gonna let Wadi walk away with that free W. He's got a lot to give to him. I'm sorry.
That was the same outcome if Wadi pressed the right button. Wadi was looking for down
that
in
is,
there.
That is true.
Yeah, I 100% believe that fair wasn't intended. But hey, you take it anyways if the man gives it to you. Watch your recovery. Watch your recovery. Ape Man's gonna drop down back area.
What a good call out
by Ape Man.
It's a common Mewtwo option, dude. Like, you normally see a lot of Mewtwos commit to neutral air out of the ledge. And honestly, I think that's what separates these two from a lot of other players in general. It's just them being a top player. They look to call out the common options depending on the character they're facing. And Ape Man knows what's the common Mewtwo option as well.
All right, I'm gonna have to ask you something real quick. I need you to name me at least two other Mewtwo players.
I can't. I would want to say Mabadongo doesn't even play Mewtwo anymore.
He don't play no Mewtwo no more. I actually had to think about that for a second when he said it's like, wait a minute. Is there even any other Mewtwos? A little bit too long on disable though. His percent's a little bit too low to actually get something off of that.
The character, like I said, the character is honestly just a buff away from being probably top tier, maybe even one of the strongest high tiers out there, and for good reason, but Wadi knows the character of just being a specialist all the way from Smash 4.
True enough. Good job. That up B grounded is really good. That up smash is so good. Ape Man uses that in every matchup so well. It's not only like just a quick anti-air option, but just like a great out of shield tool. That forward air is gonna do it, especially on the small stage. This set lead really dictates a lot right now because Wadi is starting to figure a lot of stuff out, even though Ape Man's keeping it close. Ape Man needs to remove this confidence Wadi has in his ability to play back.
All right, Wadi taking his time coming back to the stage. Gets the forward air cross up here. No neutral air. It's Ape Man who gets the first neutral air out. Wadi with the back roll, looking to try to get something against Ape Man, but look at the pressure. Able to slip through the cracks here on that roll and get that down tilt forward air. Wadi looking for the landing, the shadow ball, but no dice. Ape Man rolls back as well to get his own laser. It's kind of the battle of spacing almost, because each player wants to punish each player's commitment with a neutral air or any kind of aerial of sorts.
Good delay, because I 100% expected Ape Man to... I thought the tail was going to get scooped up.
I did too. Honestly, Ape Man had the right call, because if Wadi didn't want to go towards the ledge and avoid being at the corner, he was going to roll towards center stage. But Wadi ain't no slouch, because Ape Man is a god when it comes to that up smash.
Beautiful patience by Ape Man. That whole scramble and that last stock right there, you saw that Wadi got into kill mode, so he was trying really hard to get him back off stage so he could look for that edge guard. Ape Man caught on to that. He knew that he wasn't gonna wait in shield because he was at grab kill percentages. He had to run away, and you pretty much had to guess, does he up smash now and I try to run away, he beats out my jump, or do I swing, hopefully get him trying to up smash me? That was just a really good coin toss to Ape Man one.
Yeah. I see that the chat was talking about Zenkai. I'm sorry, I haven't seen Zenkai in quite some tournament. I usually try to keep up with Smash. Even if it's not me watching every tournament, it's like me just trying to, you know, check what's on the VODs. If you're like me, man, sometimes you don't have time to catch up with things. You use the MetaView app. And MetaView has all the clips and highlights that I want when I need to catch up with Smash. Mm-hmm. So shout out to MetaView for being a partner with 2GG. And if you're like me, man, sometimes you don't have the time. You work a full career job and you're doing crunch. So definitely shout out to MetaView for keeping me out there. And honestly, shout out to them for the partnership. But also, yeah, I'm sorry I don't know Zenkai for sure. He's probably one of the players that I have heard about before. I just haven't seen any tournaments. And me and Ajax have talked about this before. There are times where if you're not getting top three and not even winning the tournament, it's just the way the cookie crumbles, man. Sometimes yeah. they only remember the person who won the tournament, not the person who got third.
Yeah, and one thing I always love is if we don't happen to remember somebody, like I actually know who Zenkai is because he's around my area. I just forgot. But I asked for two Mewtwo's. I didn't ask for one.
But, oh, that you right. You're right, Ajax. That's why.
Yeah, all I'm saying is I only see one name there. Somebody name me another one. That's all I'm saying. And I didn't say name the best ones. I said name two other Mewtwo's. Thank you very much. So this Nair, really good day. Thank you. Hey, I don't know who Nabe is. Somebody link me to that later because I always like watching new players.
Shout out to Nick District, man. He's right. The country roads of Virginia are not smooth. I'm sorry. He's always going to get me with that one. But let's go on to game four here. Of course, Ape Man on set point and Wadi looking to hopefully get another roll. We'll see how things go. Ape Man with the patience of a mastermind here because he knows where Wadi was going to try to go to get control.
SDX doesn't play anymore.
That is true. He doesn't play anymore.
I was actually pretty surprised that Wadi decided to stick it out. I'm not necessarily upset with it. That's a downer call. Oh, that was a good mix-up. I was expecting the downer because I thought Wadi's jump was gone. And that's pretty easy to time because you can actually sound cue. So you just actually, you can't do that online. You just preemptively put it out. Drag down up airs. That is something enough Robs don't do. I don't think I should give Robs more advice, but I need to see way more drag down up airs. And that was just a really good way to condition Ape Man into shield at the ledge by baiting him out with the Shadow Ball.
Alright, Wadi looking to make that recovery, but unfortunately when you go for that confusion right off the platform, sorry, off the ledge, Ape Man is not afraid to catch those high recoveries. Like, so that's the thing about Wadi. He's gotta watch out with these high recoveries because Ape Man has been calling them out every single time. Jesus Christ.
Alright. Ape
Man.
Actually, I want a game refund after that. How dare you get to go do that huge down air, then immediately up smash afterwards. But yeah, that was just another good call. He knows that the get up options from Mewtwo is just one of a few things, particularly jump, that's a big one, especially teleporting in the center stage. And he has just beat him out. Good job doing that side B, because if he dipped low like Ape Man wanted, he was probably going to destroy him with a down air.
Yeah, the robo arms, man, just able to call out neutral get ups. But that's it. No,
you're good. Jump.
You know what it is, too, also, from Ape Man? He's been conditioning Wadi to go for those higher recoveries. Because every time Wadi tries to go for that low recovery, Ape Man has some tool out there, whether it's gyro, a downer, or a neutral air off the stage, or robo arms. It forces Wadi to consider his landing options there, unfortunately.
I see the downtown LA area is showing its true colors around you right now.
So. Yeah, oh, definitely, man. The sirens are on my end. I apologize, but... Man,
sirens out here ready...
Ready
to send Rob to jail. So this is bad. This is not good for Wadi right now. Wadi needs to actually like cheat away a stock on the last stock if he's somehow gonna win this, because he's a throwaway and he's a good straight hit away from death. Also, he's been mixed up quite a bit on ledge because he's been getting called out in his jumps, which makes that side B a lot easier to try and call out on the neutral getup. Ooh, side B dodges it. Hold up. This is high percentage. Oh, he gets him with a fair. Hold on now. I'm not saying. Look, there's a chance. Wadi believers with your points. There is still a chance.
Yeah, man. If you're holding all the chips right now, you haven't lost it yet. Oh, no. I stand corrected.
Oh, he got the check. Wadi. Okay, man, okay, okay. 200%.
He this said, is how I you will just... live. Oh, no. Not back to the... No, Wadi, please.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, the gyro's in the way. Okay, hold up. 218 to 0%. All right, you dead.
Look,
never mind.
Ape Man told Wadi, look, in SoCal, the taco stand is open at every corner all night. If you want to stay there, bro, I'm going to help you stay at the corner because the tacos are free tonight. And unfortunately, you're going to lose. The Ape Man wins 3-1. And that was rough, man, because Wadi lifted 200 and he could not get off that corner.
My man was absolutely refusing to let Wadi actually play the game that last stock. Kept throwing.